Welcome back, everyone, to the lecture about applied bioimage analysis. After spending weeks with Fiji and some general introduction to image analysis, I would like to show you some other tools for image analysis in the life sciences or in biology. And we start with Cell Profiler today. And I'm happy that Beth Simony was sharing some material with me. She works in the Broad Institute in Carpenter's lab, where Cell Profiler is made, where it's maintained. And I'm happy that I got some material from her for giving you an insight into Cell Profiler. So on her first flight, it's actually quite cool. She has already the point. So while in ImageJ in Fiji, we open images individually and treat them individually and then have quite some work to do in order to build a workflow which is able to process hundreds or thousands of images. That's the major goal of Cell Profiler. So the idea of processing one image or 1 million images, that the workflow behind should be the same, or the effort of doing this should be as minimal as possible for going from one to the other. That was basically the idea behind Cell Profiler. So there is different softwares in the Cell Profiler universe, let's say. So Cell Profiler and Cell Profiler Analyst, while the Analyst is more like the advanced version, let's say, where you can do a lot more with images and machine learning and data analysis, like a lot of stuff. We will today just look in Cell Profiler, and I would like to just show you how a workflow, an image analysis workflow in Cell Profiler looks like. So Cell Profiler has quite some history. When you look back, I think it was published in 2003, thousands of citations. So obviously people are working with this software, and obviously there must be a reason behind, right? So Ann Carpenter started developing it, then some other people took over. Now there's a whole lab with many people working there, actually working on this, still maintaining the platform, still making new platforms actually for similar purposes. Cell Profiler is, from the image analysis point of view, very similar to many other tools. Images in, data out. So you have on the one side, you have pixels and often multi-channel images, fluorescent microscopy delivering different views on the same cells. You have steps like thresholding, steps like segmentation and so on, and connected components analysis on the way towards numbers. But there is one major difference between what we have seen earlier, ImageJ and Cell Profiler. The philosophy here is they try to measure everything and look into the data later and find out what is reasonable, what is a reliable measurement for the thing they are observing in the images. So while we are in ImageJ quite precisely selecting individual measurements for the biological property we would like to access, in Cell Profiler they measure everything they can, and then afterwards with data mining techniques, with machine learning techniques, they look deeper into the data and try to find out what else is there than just cell size or number of cells, right? So that's a bit the idea behind. So Cell Profiler is one of the major players in the high content screening image analysis field. So imagine the following. You want to develop a new pharmaceutical against the virus, which is spreading over the world, for example. And in order to do this, you cannot just develop it and bring it to the humans, right? You have to go through certain levels of clinical studies. And one of these levels is where you take the chemical and you put it with cells together in a dish and you observe what the chemical is doing to the cells. And ideally, you do this under different concentrations of the chemical. Likely, you will not just develop one chemical. Likely, you will develop thousands and study their effects on cells. And in order to do this in an efficient way, the field of high content screening basically came up. So the scientists in this field take well plates. So you see them here, many of them on the top row. You put a lot of cells in there, cultures, and you expose these cultures to chemicals or to different concentrations of chemicals. And then you put them into fully automated microscopes, which take images of these cells, maybe over time, to screen some kind of different properties you can modify, you can manipulate in these well plates. So high content screening means there are generated automatically with microscopes thousands of images of cells, and you would like to analyze them in a reproducible manner. Automated microscopy deliver images. These images go into the Cell Profiler, where the actual segmentation and image analysis is done, and then you go further to the Cell Profiler Analyst, where you can then further analyze the data. So for the image-based essays, the basic objectives are you want to identify different parts in the image. So that's what we did already, right? We were detecting cells, we were segmenting cells. Maybe we want to segment or detect things inside cells. So this is when it becomes one level more complicated. And you want, of course, you want to measure features of interest. So feature extraction. So this is basically what all essays have in common. And what's different between different essays is what you want to identify. So as I just said, are there just cells? You want to measure how many there are, maybe over time or after a certain period of time? Or is there objects inside the cells which you want to investigate, which you want to count? So what's relevant? So and this is what's different between different workflows. That's where ZProfiler is actually strong, right? ZProfiler has a nice website with a lot of tutorials, YouTube videos, and so on. So you can find a lot of more information about that. I will leave it at that point and just show you how the software works. So as you can see, ZProfiler opens a couple of images. Maybe I click the command line away for the moment. And then we'll also, you have this nice starting page here, which points you to the website, which points you to tutorials, demos, the manual, and so on. So quite practical. So I will also click this one away. And the cool thing, without knowing too much technical details, you can easily follow what the software is telling you. So the software in this case tells us, drop an image here. So I will just drop an image here. Let me go one step further. And we will not extract metadata for today. So the information behind what you have to learn for this is a bit more complicated. And that's why I will not go much deeper here. But I wanted to at least give you a view inside. So assuming your microscope was taking images from the well plate, so the microscope knew at which position the images were taken, and the images are, for example, also saved for each channel individually, you could use these fields here, a so-called regular expression, to read out all this information out of the file name. And that allows the software to interpret where the image comes from in a good way. We will not need it in the exercise today. That's why I will leave this step out, but you should know that behind this radio button here, there's a strength of ZProfiler. And I just leave it out for today because I would like to show you more about image processing workflows. So you find here a field where you just have to enter the image name, and I just took input image. Furthermore, you can also group your data. That might be relevant later during your exercise, but you don't have to do this. Yeah? So I'm just saying you can. And you already see that I'm going here in this list on the left. I go from the top to the bottom. And we haven't done anything yet, right? We have just loaded images. And here on the bottom, you find a plus button. So obviously, we can add things. And I'm explaining it in this way because you can kind of approach many new softwares you have never used before like that. Especially in the image analysis field, you often find whatever kind of abstract representation of a workflow, and then there is a plus button, and you can add new steps. And in ZProfiler, it works like this. Let me just make a little bit of space. So I just clicked this plus button here, and I come to this window where I see different categories. So I can obviously do things with files, I can do things with images, I can do things with objects, and with measurements. And I think I don't even have to go further in the other groups because that's all we need. The only thing we have to clarify is what the terminology behind is. So basically, we were talking in the last weeks, we were talking about images and then about selections in images, regions of interest, masks, binary images, I was saying labeled images. And here it's called a little bit differently. So but basically, the same concepts are behind. So when we talk about images, obviously, it's the same. And what they mean with objects here is basically the binarization of our images, so binary images or labeled images or regions of interest. Every region of interest in an image, which also may correspond to a label in a labeling image, is an object in ZProfiler. So you start from images. From the images, you make selections of objects, and then you can measure objects. So this is how ZProfiler uses the terminology. Let's assume we have, this blobs.gif I'm always using. We want to do some noise removal at the very beginning. Then we do some thresholding. From the thresholding, we go further to connected components analysis, and then we do a measurement. We measure the size of the blob. So this is our standard, my favorite standard workflow I'm doing all the time. So let's see if we can find the steps for that. So we start, of course, with image processing. The image is loaded in the back because I entered already the file name. And we start with image processing, and first step, denoising, is applying a filter. And when you think a bit about, when you go through this list here and you try to find out where the filters could be, the smooth should jump into your face. So I will, as a first step, add some smoothing. Then I already said it, the next step is then segmentation, it's the threshold. And then when from the threshold to a labeled image, that's connected components analysis. So it must be between images and objects. So when you go here through this list, when we are still in image processing, you do not really find something about getting objects out of that. So let's look in the object category, in the object processing category, and you find here convert image to objects. So this is the step we want to do next. And obviously, when we have the objects, we want to measure their size. For example, we want to do some measurements. So we have a look here. And when you go through this list, we can, for example, measure object size and shape. So this is how the terminology in Cell Profiler looks like. After measuring object size and shape, we may want to save the results of our measurement to disk. And we find that hopefully, yeah, we find it here. So for example, we want to export to a spreadsheet file. So you see now in our workflow here at the top with these green arrows, everything is all good. And then here is obviously some problem. There's a, and it tells us already not in input image. So let's see what it means with that. Select the input image. That's the error message here tells us that we haven't selected an input image yet. So we have to select an input image here. And we have to call the output image in a way that's there is per default something I will just enter a little bit different here that we can see the filtered image. And then we have to select this moving method. And we can here, for example, you know, these guys already apply a Gaussian or median filter. So I will for today just go to a median filter. We could configure the parameters for this median filter ourselves. So for example, we can enter a median of 2 or median of 3 if you just want to remove some noise, right? And we could also leave here the automatic determination of a diameter. I don't know how it works, but I bet one could look it up by clicking here on the question mark button. So then the next step is thresholding. Also, thresholding has here an error message. The error message is input image is not selected. So we have to now decide. So you see this pull-down becomes longer from step to step, yeah? So we could now change if we want to, we could now define if we want to threshold the input image or if we want to threshold the filtered image. Obviously, we want to filter, we want to threshold the filtered image. And if you see, we go from image number one, from input image to the filtered image. Now we go from the filtered image to the thresholded image. So obviously, this is a workflow. Obviously, this is a leading from one image to another, and it's a chain of image processing methods applied here in a row. So this error tells us that everything is good, and we go to the next step, and here also there is an error message. I bet it has something to do with the input image. Yeah. So we have to select the input image. We want to, of course, connect components analysis. So from image to objects is obviously connected components analysis. We want to do with the thresholded image. I will just call it connected components analysis result. And then we want to measure. And also here, we just have to configure what objects we would like to measure. And this pull-down is not as long as the others because the results of these two steps are images, while the result of that step is objects. And we can process objects like that. And then finally, we would like to export everything to a file. Per default, the default location is an output folder, which is in my case located somewhere here. You can also just select, for example, a folder on the desktop. We could now configure in very detail what we want to output. We could also, in the threshold step, for example, configure quite in detail what we want to, how we want to approach that. Basically, I try to keep it as simple as possible. Also, when you later do the exercise with Cell Profiler, try to leave all the default values as they are, but look a bit around. So, for example, here in this pull-down, you find O2, and you know already how the O2 method works. Maybe you know also from the images I will show you later for the exercise, maybe you know already that these images may be easy to process, easy processable with the O2 method. So then you can pick it here or you can pick any other method. But in general, I would just leave the default parameters for now because they are kind of carefully selected by the developers of this tool. And we can have a look on the results. And there's two different modes inside Profiler. So assume you have configured at the beginning a folder with 1 billion images. You don't want to click on start now and then wait until this 1 billion images are processed. You may want to enter the so-called start mode and just go through some steps and see what the results of these steps are, right? So let's just start with the first step. So obviously we see on the left side, original image, on the right side, filtered image. So we can here now look at the differences between these two images. Then we can go for the next step and we see on the left side, the original image and on the right side, the thresholded image. By increasing this window, we can also fix the view here. And we can also read out the threshold, which was actually used for processing these images. So the next step would then be turning this into objects. So this is obviously connected components analysis, and we have it now in colors. But we can do some measurements. And the measurements, so that's already again the next step. And the measurements end up in a big table, and we haven't configured what to measure because the philosophy of Cell Profiler is measure everything. So this table is a bit long, but not too bad. And we can just could now just do the next step, but data is not written to spreadsheets in test mode. So in order to get actually data out, we have to exit the test mode and analyze images. Always a good idea to save the project by the end. And I was saving data to a new folder on my desktop. And you see now here three Excel tables. The reason for having three Excel tables and not just one table with measurements is actually Cell Profiler would like to store all its data to a relational database. So they do more with that than just looking into tables, right? You remember high throughput, you have millions of images, different conditions, at a different time point, different places on the web plate and so on. And in the, organizing all that in a single two-dimensional table is a bit hard. That's why it makes more sense to save everything to a database, or the very basic, the most basic version of a database is several tables on a hard drive. And in order to find out what area our cells in this data set had, we just open all these files and look into it, and we try to find out what is in there. Then you kind of increase here a bit the columns, and you can find out that there is the area column. You can also furthermore see here image number and object number. So that means somewhere there must be a list of images and somewhere there must be a list of objects. And this is these other tables. So when I go here into the image table, you find also here the image number and the file name. So if you later apply this whole algorithm to many images in the exercise, for example, this is how you deal with these different informations, which is spread over a couple of tables. It will not be so complicated in the exercise. You will manage that. Furthermore, one important thing, as you have seen, there are these images, these windows popping up all the time. And we already found it annoying in ImageJ that all these windows are popping up all the time. You can prevent that by turning the eye off here. And that will lead to this process being executed. And after some time, you see that this workflow is executed without popping up all the images. So especially when your workflow becomes much longer, and you have different steps with objects and sub-objects and so on, you may want to turn off the visualization of each individual step. Okay, this is it for Cell Profiler for now. The next lesson will be about image processing in 9. See you soon.